This tutorial shows 1. How to test an object-oriented program using the standard test case class, and 2. How the change from static to dynamic binding can affect the behavior of a program. Here's the class diagram generated from the source code by the Gannett Programming Studio. To keep this tutorial simple, the class hierarchy involves only 2 levels. However, the concepts presented may be applied to a hierarchy of any depth. The test hierarchy, shown here, shadows the application hierarchy. And inherited tests are applied to inherited methods in the corresponding application class. At this time, please note that getSumOfValues calls the function getValue2, which is declared in the root and overridden in branch. The function sumOfSquares is new to branch. Okay, let's examine the application in some detail. In root, we declare a top-level class, C_root, with 2 instance variables, val1 and val2. We also provide a class-wide pointer as a courtesy to client programmers. Here we declare primitive operations on the class and getSumOfValues is left in a state right now where it involves a concrete class. In the body of root, we implement the interface methods setval1, setval2, getval2, and here we have getSumOfValues. Note that the function getSumOfValues contains a call to getValue2. Because the object parameter is a tag type, the function getSumOfValues will always invoke getValue2 declared in this package. This is a compile time dependency. As a result, when the message getSumOfValues is sent to C_branch, the overridden getValue2 will be ignored. In order for getSumOfValues to invoke getValue2 on C branch, we must enable dynamic binding by specifying C_root as a class-wide type, as shown in the code that's been commented out. So, don't forget, unlike Java and C#, dynamic dispatching is not the default behavior in Ada. It only occurs when a class-wide declaration is present. C branch is derived from C root, which means branch inherits the know-how to set value 1, set value 2, and getSumOfValues. Program in its current state will ignore the overridden getValue2 function. Instead, the version of root is called. SumOfSquares is a new method. GetValue2 in C branch returns a dummy value that will cause an assertion to fail. All right, this concludes Part 1 of 2 of the tutorial testing a class hierarchy with standard test case class. In part two, we will examine the test code.